In mourning, a community so important to them to honor the victims. Three vigils today planned. One has already happened, one is underway, and there's another one later tonight. So this community, this close-knit community, Parkland, is about to honor its victims, and that's what they want people to remember. The people, the heroes who died in the school, and the students that were senselessly gunned down. Let's bring in Nestor Amato now. He spoke with the mayor of Parkland and talked about how difficult, everybody knew everybody here. It wasn't that big of a community.
Yeah, that's right. In fact, when she got the call about an active shooter, she was only 15 minutes away. This is a very small city, close-knit city, and the mayor tells me that she's really trying to hold it together. She knows people are looking at her for guidance. They're looking at her for support. So she's trying to keep it together. But as a mother, she tells me she's devastated.
It was just before 3 yesterday afternoon.
I got the call. I remember they were responding to an active shooter alarm.
Mayor Christine Honchowski of Parkland says she thought it was a false alarm. She was just 15 minutes away from Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High, so she took the short drive over.
I remember seeing parents slowly getting here.
Then she heard the sirens blaring closer and closer. That's when she realized it was the real thing.
The girls, they had their makeup and they had been crying.
Her small city seeing tragedy many other places could never imagine.
As a mother, to see the parents yesterday and see the children, it was heartbreaking.
She tells me she realizes now it could happen anywhere.
And it's moments like this you realize life can change in a minute and how precious it is.
So the mayor says her city is tiny but mighty. They're resilient. They're going to work together to get through this, and they're going to try to work together to make sure it doesn't happen again. Kelly.
That is something that so many people are talking about. They never thought it would happen here.
No. I mean, just last year, Parkland, Florida was named the safest city in the state.
Yeah, so they were very proud of that moniker, yeah. And to have this happen here, a lot of people are just in disbelief.